she's a good girl. Loves her mama, loves Jesus. In America too, she's a good girl. She's crazy about Elvis, loves horses. And her boyfriend too. It's a long day living in Reseda. There's a freeway.
Look, this is accusing someone of a crime. And in our country, when we accuse someone of a crime, we want it to be a process. Due process is important. The ability for that person who's been accused of a crime to face their accusers and to be at the table when they're interviewed so that they can prepare a defense.
And if so, what basis do you have for making that insinuation?
We have not spoken directly with the whistleblower. We would like to, but I'm sure the whistleblower has concerns that he has not been advised, as the law requires, by the inspector.
The essence of what the president communicates. We've been very good to your country, very good. No other country has done as much as we have. But you know what? I don't see much reciprocity here. I hear what you want. I have a favor I want from you, though. And I'm going to say this only 7 times, so you better listen good. This is, in sum and character, what the president was trying to communicate.
Now, he also declined to comment when I asked him if anybody on his staff knew the identity of the whistleblower.
Ivanovich, a deep state resistance numbskull, blocked Ukrainian officials from going to the United States to deliver evidence of the Obama administration pressuring the Ukrainian government to interfere in the election. Look at this tweet. This is huge. A former U.S. ambassador blocked Ukrainian officials from going to the United States to deliver evidence of the Obama administration pressuring the Ukrainian government to interfere in the 2016 election. They continue that in 2018, Ukraine President Zelensky tried to give evidence over to the Trump administration of how the Obama administration, including Vice President Joe Biden, serious misconduct during the 2016 election. They write that Ukraine is not the only foreign country that the Obama administration pressured into spying on the Trump campaign to skirt around U.S. laws. Very simple. No, we're not spying on American citizens. But New Zealand is. Italy is. Australia is. The United Kingdom, they are.
What is best in the interests of wanting to take down a sitting president? Maybe you should ask what was said inside of Volcker's deposition during his transcribed interview with regards to Adam Schiff's fairy tale quid pro quo charge that aid from the United States to Ukraine was being linked to an investigation into the Bidens. Why don't you ask, what did Ambassador Volcker say about that? Ambassador Volcker testified about how the readouts of the phone call that was made to him, that there was nothing in the readouts about there being a hold on U.S. aid or a quid pro quo.
Our committee, the Oversight Committee, probably deals with more whistleblowers than any other committee in Congress. And the first thing two things you always look at to determine the credibility of the so-called whistleblower is, did they have first-hand knowledge and what's their motivation?
And sadly, what we are seeing here is nothing new. It's the same Schiff, different day. Play on words. As Congressman Jordan pointed out, this fits his pattern. Schiff seems to have a hand in virtually every conspiratorial anti-Trump smear brought before Congress. For example, summer of 2018, there was the shifty Schiff, the cowardly Schiff, a secret meeting with Fusion GPS founder Glenn Simpson, you know, the guy that Robert Mueller had never heard of. Prepped Michael Cohen for 10 hours just before his testimony before his committee on Capitol Hill. Wow.
The president himself called on the Russians to assist his campaign by hacking Hillary Clinton's emails. He was using that office as leverage to obtain dirt, to have another country manufacture dirt on his opponent.
We believe that the president of the United States is engaged in a cover-up. I think right now there's a cover-up of the cover-up.
The Russians offered help. The campaign accepted help. The Russians gave help, and the president made full use of that help.
I don't think we can rely on a country that is so beholden to the good graces of Donald Trump to be able to level with us on this.
no one is above the law, especially the President of the United States. The President believes that he is above the law being the Constitution of the United States.
There is already, in my view, ample evidence in the public domain on the issue of collusion, if you're willing to see it.
It is very powerful evidence of that kind of potential impeachable offense.
See a pattern? It would almost be funny if they weren't trying to circumvent the will of you, the American people, and literally remove a duly elected president from office who's doing an amazing job under the worst circumstances.
Can you explain to me, A, why it's the U.S. intelligence community's responsibility to listen to the president of the United States speaking to a foreign leader, and B, why the U.S. intelligence community, under the rules provided by the Democrats in Congress, are responsible to report to the Congress what the President of the United States says? Last I checked, Chris, when I served, we're responsible for chasing the Russians, the Chinese, the Iranians, and terrorists. We're not responsible for reporting to the Congress what the President says. He can say what he wants, Chris.